up. We're gonna cut some fingers out of some chicken breasts. Me and Chris just picked them up at the grocery store. I had to make sure that they were thawed because I knew I was about to cook them. So they're still colder than I normally would cook them. Normally I'd let them sit out, you know, just a few minutes and let them soak in the buttermilk. But today I'm going to be in a little bit more of a hurry than I normally am. So I'm just cutting like this part off because my kids are not going to want to get that in their mouth when they go to eat a chicken finger. And I'm just trimming them up and cutting fingers out of them. Then we're going to rinse them off just a little bit and throw them in some buttermilk. And if you want to know why I'm rinsing them, because I don't always rinse them, because they don't smell the best, actually, tonight, to me. So whenever something smells a little bit like it's not the freshest, I like to rinse it. Most of the time, I don't rinse my chicken otherwise. All right, it's really just a few of us, so I think that's enough. That's three breasts, and that's quite a few fingers. So I'm going to run them under some water and put them in this dish right quick. And then I'm gonna put a little buttermilk on them, and I've got some whole buttermilk, which will cling to them pretty good. Chris cut up the fish earlier, so his filet knife's still in the sink, and I can smell fish on it. Might be what I smell instead of my chicken. We went fishing. Where'd you go fishing today, Chris?
Crooked River, up at Harriet's Bluff.
We done pretty good. Caught three keepers.
Yeah, three nice trout.
Speckled trout. Now, I'm going to wash my hands at this point. And yes, I picked up the bottle. I'll wash it off too. And we're going to get these in some buttermilk and get them started frying. We got our oil already heating up, so I'm not going to take the time to worry about my cutting board at this minute. We're going to concentrate mostly on getting these breaded and ready for the fryer. So I've got some whole buttermilk I'm going to pour on top of them. And while they soak for a minute, go ahead and mix them up a little bit, and then I gotta rinse my hands off again. And while they soak for a minute, we're gonna mix up some good flour, some seasoned flour to cook them in. And of course, we're gonna be using White Lily. We are now sponsored by White Lily. And I just made me a sign to go on the wall, and that way, because I'm bad about buying my flour and dumping it in my bins and not saving the bag. So I made me a sign for the wall just so that Chris could show the sign, because I can't always show my White Lily bag. All right, so we're gonna get out, we've got out our self-rising flour. I do like to use self-rising flour. It makes a crunchier crust. You can always add a little cornstarch if all you got self, if you wanna make it even more crunchy. We're gonna put a little bit of this in here. And there's an actual recipe for these if you want to go buy it.
Go buy the recipe.
Yeah.
Not go purchase the recipe.
Oh, no. I think they know what I mean.
Or go buy it.
All right. And so it has paprika, some ranch seasoning, and I bought me some new ranch seasoning, and it's not in here. Must be still in the pantry because this has kind of gotten, you know, like, it's pretty old. Over time, things get old. So we put paprika in it. We put ranch seasoning in it. I'll just pick that up. We put pepper and salt.
Mm-hmm.
And we mix that up.
And this was Amy's request.
This is hard.
For her birthday.
So I've got to smash it.
She turns 19 today.
Yep, she gets to be 19 today. Or she is 19 today.
So we told her she could have anything she wanted.
Of course she wants these. This is my kid favorite. Yeah. My chicken fingers, and they like honey mustard. I'm not making the honey mustard. I actually have some Ken's honey mustard, and we're going to be using that for supper instead. So this is really good. The ratios, if you use my directions for my recipe, you'll find that the ratios are really good. I'm going to turn this up to high. And while I'm waiting on that to get really hot, we're going to bread these because they need to be breaded just a minute before you throw them in there. You can see how fluffy this flour is. When you put something in, it's like it just falls down in there. It's so nice, and there's really no need to have to sift white lily flour. It's always just great.
Which cookbook is this in? It's in the first one, isn't it?
Yeah.
The chicken finger?
Yeah, this is something I make all the time. So, of course, it's in my first cookbook. First cookbook's going to have stuff in it that we just pretty much can't live without, you know, that we just make all the time. Because that's the first things I started cooking for Collar Valley Cooks were our favorites. We're always the first. In there first.
And she didn't have any recipes written down for hardly any of them. She had to start writing down the recipes.
Yeah, I had to figure out what I was doing.
Yeah, make it the same way every time.
Yeah, and if you go by the recipe for this, I'm telling you, the ratio for the salt and the pepper and the paprika is really good. And I probably should have went by it myself. If I hadn't have been live, I would have got out my cookbook and done it right. Sometimes when I'm live, I'm a little bit more wild on camera. It's a lot harder to cook live than you realize. It's real easy to mess up. And so, and I hate for y'all to have to wait on me. This is a really big piece of chicken. I don't like the size of that piece of chicken. It really needs to be cut in half. I'm gonna save it right here. You want to make sure most of your chicken is about the same size, because you don't want one that's overcooked and gets, you know, tough, and then one that don't get cooked enough. I'm going to throw a little flour in here, a little extra. And so you got to be careful and make sure the pieces are about the same size, really. We just went to the post office today, and we had lots of Christmas cards. Boy, do I love them. I was reading them, opening them up and reading them to Chris on the way home when we went to get the chicken. Because, you know, we've been out of town a few days. Thanks to everybody that sent Christmas cards. I'll probably show them in another video, maybe. I like to take Christmas cards and cut the pretty picture off the front and use it for a tag on my Christmas presents the next year. It's fun to do. All you gotta do is get you a pair of scissors and trim off those pretty cards. Don't waste them. Trim them up, punch a hole in them, put a little ribbon on them, and you got a nice name tag for your presents. Works great. But I love reading them. I love getting stuff in the mail. I got a couple of gifts in the mail, and I got a couple of really nice little notes. And it's always very encouraging when you go to the mailbox and you got nice things like that to get in the mailbox. All right, I am going to cut this. Reach back here and get my knife right through the middle. That would just slip by me. I'm going to dip it in this buttermilk a little bit. Bring it back over here to the flour. And then we're going to do a test piece with what's left on my fingers just to see how hot this is. Getting pretty warm. I think I can drop them. Now, these are really cold, so when they hit that water, I mean that oil, Lord of mercy, crazy. When they hit that oil, I'm going to rinse my hands off before I drop them. Because it ain't going to hurt. We're with a gas stove, it doesn't get near as hot as an electric stove, so I have time to rinse my hands off. And I only cook these a few minutes per side because I do cut them pretty thin. So just make sure that you rinse your hands good, you get your skillet preheated, get your oil in there. We're using peanut oil tonight, and we do not reuse it when we're using it for meat. I will reuse oil when I use it for vegetables, but not for meat. And we're just going to throw some french fries in the air fryer. She likes a ride of golden crinkles. Well, that'll be easy. All right, here we go. I'm going to use my meat hook. And that way I don't have to touch the chicken again. Lord, I just about got myself.
Hooked yourself.
Mm-hmm. And I think I'll cook these in two batches. And as soon as I get all of them in there, I'm going to set my timer. Was that two? Yes. Lordy. It's a long one. That's it. All right, so we're going for 4 minutes and hit the start button on the timer. And while we're doing that, we can clean up our mess. I got a couple of things, neat things for Christmas I was going to show y'all. I got this from Missy Patty. I get my jewelry from her, from Paparazzi, and she sent me this. And I'm actually going to, I've actually decided what I'm going to do with these two mixes. This is a chocolate chip cookie mix with a spatula and a package of Betty Crocker mix. And then this one is a winter warm wish mix. It has cinnamon muffins in it with a little cutting board. And this is from my sister. And since the kids are coming home and then they'll be going back to college, I got a couple of, what are these little boxes I had sitting in there, Chris? Boxes that I had sitting right there.
There's a bunch of them on the back porch.
Oh, yeah. So, I got these last year after Christmas marked down. And they're little boxes. So, I'm going to make those chocolate chip cookies. And I'm going to make those little cinnamon muffins and put them in these little boxes. And when the kids go back to college, they can give their friends a little sweet treat for Christmas.
That'd be nice.
And so, we may do that tomorrow. And I'm just going to use those little mixes and make the kids something. I thought that'd be nice. I'm going to start cleaning up.
You're going to cook it 4 minutes aside? Yeah. We got 2 minutes left on this side. Looks good. Love fried chicken.
Nothing better than fried chicken.
Nope. Me and Amy is our favorite. Well, I don't know if it's Amy's favorite. But what she wanted for her birthday.
This is a, y'all are always asking me what I use and what I have. This is a, the dishwasher is a Bosch. I love it. I put everything in it. I dishwash just about everything. And so like that thing, I cut up the chicken. I dishwash even my sharp knives if they're flat, not serrated, because I can sharpen them. If they're not, if they're serrated, I hand wash them. But if they're not, I put them in the dishwasher. I put a lot of stuff in my dishwasher. And I told y'all some of y'all have been my viewers for quite a while and know that when you rinse flour, take it up off your counter, you should use, for one, a scraper so you don't have to make as big of a mess on your dish towel. And then for another, you should use a wash rag that's a little bit cool and not warm, because if the water's warm, it makes it pasty and sticky. And if the water's cool, that flour will just come right up off the countertop and do real good for cleaning up. Is it time to clean it?
20 seconds. It's looking good.
Now we're only going to do the other side 3 minutes because that's what I want to do.
That oil's pretty big.
And they're thin. They're pretty small. If you overcook your chicken, it gets chewy. And I just turn this down just a little bit, because it's a little bit too warm. This is our braiser, and it's the Avalon, that's the name of it. On our website, it's the one that, there's three for ones now, I think. This one is the Avalon. Y'all see it. It may be out of stock. You may just have to wait till they get it back in stock. But it's one of my favorite things to cook in.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that went out of stock this year.
Yeah, really. I can't produce it. That's just the demand, because more people are cooking at home. And so, well, I did something wrong. Just wants to fuss at me, don't it?
There you go.
All right, so I'm going to put a lid on this so I can find it. So when you're live, you always have plenty of time to do something else. We had a good time this Christmas at Chris's mom and daddy's. We stayed 3 nights there, and then we stayed a couple of nights in my hometown, and that was fun. Sometimes I have a hard time getting these underneath there, so I just pull it out and then put them in. Sometimes it's just easier to do that, but I definitely need to get my fresh dressing put in there. The heck with that old stuff. What you showing them?
Chicken. Stuff is falling on me.
Now we get something to stick it on. We'll set it right here. When it's done, and I need to, I guess I'll throw it on the plate and then put it over there. It's done. I'm getting it out.
Nothing wrong with that. Pretty. I wish I could smell that.
Oh, it smells good, don't it? Mm-hmm. This is a good dinner, even if it is a kid dinner. Chris loves it, don't you, Chris? Mm-hmm. Right up his alley, this kid dinner.
I'm a kid, too.
All right, we're going to put the rest of these in here. And then while these are cooking, we're going to start our French fries. Lord, I'm working so hard, ain't I? It's such an easy supper, y'all. Should make it. It's a real thin piece. I'm gonna put it in the middle because my flame is around the edges more because of the gas. That's how it's applied on the edges of the pan. All right. There we go. Now we can get this one in the dishwasher.
We've never had anybody complain about these chicken fingers. Everybody that makes them,
they love them, don't they?
Likes them.
Yep. They're really good. All right, we're going to wrap up our chicken, and then we're going to start our French fries. So I keep food wrap in a large thing. And if you're cooking for real, you should always never quit moving in the kitchen. Don't get on the phone and get distracted. Concentrate on the kitchen. So clean up your mess, wash your dishes, put up your food, all that stuff, so that when supper gets done, you don't have so much left to do. We got us some good collards at the grocery store today, because y'all know, got to make collard greens for the new year. Some people make cabbage, but I was raised, of course, in Collard Valley, and we make collards. Now I've got to wipe this cabinet off because it's where the chicken was. And, I mean, I didn't just put it on the counter or nothing, but to be safe, we will rinse it off with some soap. The other side of my rag is not that soap, so I'm gonna rinse it. We are getting it done, y'all. Getting it done. That's simple. So now is our French fry. I didn't set the timer, did I?
No, but when it gets to,
watch.
I know what time you started.
Okay.
When it gets to 6, you're good.
What do you mean 6?
6.
It's going up instead of down. So how's it going to get to?
When it gets to 6.
6 o'clock.
Yeah.
6:00.
6.
I thought you meant 6 on the end of the 58.
No, 6.
All right, so we're going to do some. Look, I've got tater tots in here. Thins. So we're going to do some French fries. And I'm going to show y'all how brown they get and how quick they cook in here. Now, if you make homemade fries in an air fryer, they take twice as long as frozen French fries. So when you press your air fryer button for French fries, remember that it's really, this thing's not plugged in. Honey, come back around this way so that they don't. We're not behind the back. Okay. So, there's the French fry button. We're going to press it. It's at 25 minutes, but it won't take it 25 minutes. It'll only take it about 15 minutes at the most. And it's deep brown and crunchy. It's so good. 6 o'clock. So it's time to flip, right?
Time to flip.
And some of y'all are probably saying, well, that touched the raw chicken, and you're going to use it. Well, I'm going to stick it down here in this oil, and that's so hot. If there's anything on it, it's going to be dead. So that don't matter no more. There we go. We're going to flip it.
Plus, the chicken's going to keep cooking, too.
Well, yeah.
That you touch. Yeah.
This is getting pretty warm on the bottom, enough to make it look dark on the bottom in places. This piece of chicken's real fat. This one right here. And it seems like this part of my pan is the hottest part. So I'm going to put it over there. All right, we're going to set this one. These are thicker, so I'm going to go a whole number, 4 minutes again. And I did turn it down just a little bit because it's getting just a little bit too brown. And let's get out our honey mustard.
That's the thing with the
beautiful. Go ahead, Chris.
I was going to say, that's the thing with buttermilk. You know, when you cook chicken with buttermilk, it gets dark faster than like an egg wash.
Okay, yeah, that's a good thing to talk about right now. We do our chicken fingers with buttermilk because they do cook 4 minutes and 4 minutes. When you do, because it does get darker with buttermilk, the coating gets darker. When you use an egg wash, the coating is lighter. So when you're using an egg wash is when you should use for bone-in chicken. Because if you use the buttermilk with bone-in chicken and it's in the pan 20 minutes or so, your chicken gets too dark, okay? So keep that in mind. So when you're doing your chicken fingers, use your buttermilk. And when you're doing your bone-in chicken, use an egg wash. And we use a different spice as well for bone-in chicken. We use Chris's special spice blend. And you can search that if you want to check it out. But look at these beautiful Christmas cactuses. It got to about 30 degrees the night before we left and were out of town, and I was afraid that I had let them get too cold, and I brought them in, and they were all just budded, and I was afraid I was going to miss their beauty, and I did it. They're just gorgeous. So come over here and show them up close while they're waiting on the chicken how pretty they are.
This one's already lost some. It's getting, it's just now budding.
Yeah. That's my little one, and then this is the one I've had for several years. We brought them with us from Dallas when we moved here this summer. They're really pretty, aren't they, y'all? So pretty. And we're just using Ken's honey mustard tonight. Normally I make it, there is a recipe in a recipe book. And this is light. I didn't even realize I got light honey mustard. I hope it's good. We don't normally eat light things. You can tell by looking at us. So they got about a minute and a half left on them. You can use a shield while you're frying and it won't get all over the place like I'm letting it do. But I can't do that when I'm videoing because then you can see the pretty food. But I do have one. I'm just not using it. I keep it hung on the cabinet. Because we use it pretty much a good bit. Some of these are thinner than others, so I'm going to start getting out the thin ones. But the ones that are really fat, I'm going to let them go the extra minute.
And some people put a lid on their chicken, don't they?
When they do bone-in, they do.
Yeah. That would be kind of like having a lid on it a little bit.
I'm going to rotate these and let them cook the last minute on the other side.
Same color as those others, aren't they? They're
yeah.
Just a maybe a touch darker. They look good.
If it's an eight one, y'all, sign off. Amy will be walking in the door any minute. We're going to have a nice pate. And then we're headed to the airport to pick up Keisha. So y'all pay for safe travels to the airport and back, and we're going to celebrate our Christmas tomorrow, so I'm sure I'll be cooking something up tomorrow for y'all too. This off, and then I'm going to show you the French fries. still have some time to go, but they're getting nice and toasty. And I like them crunchy and brown. So they'll continue to cook. It may take them a little longer. You never know. I hope y'all have a wonderful night. Let's get a bite of this. And I'm going to show y'all how good it is. Put some honey mustard in here. My chicken fingers are so good with honey mustard. They really are. Or you can use whatever dip you like the best.
Crunchy.
Good. You can't beat white lily self-rising flour, can you? Woo! That's a good supper for a birthday. Y'all have a wonderful night, and thanks for watching Colored Valley Cooks, where we cook like Mama did. Bye, y'all. Love ya.